Hi there, and welcome back to the Catholic History Minute. Today we're going to have a quick chat about the Inquisition. Now, you probably remember after a recent terror attack how President Obama compared Muslim extremism to the great sins of the Church, namely the Crusades and the Inquisition. And it's true that sinful acts have been committed by Catholic men and women in the name of the Church, and we'll discuss many of those occurrences on this channel. The problem is that the Crusades and the Inquisition are bad examples of this. In fact, they're the exact opposite of terrorism. We'll get to the Crusades in many later videos, but the issue of the Inquisition is something we Catholics need to understand, so we'll start there today. In an article entitled Obama, the Crusades and the Inquisition, Why the President's Right and His Critics Are Wrong, Reverend Mark Woods lays out what many people, including Catholics, believe about the Inquisition. Here's an excerpt. The Inquisition was a set of institutions within the Roman Catholic Church, charged with preserving it from heresy. It did this by means of burning people at the stake, torture through hanging people from chains, the rack, the thumbscrews, and other measures too gruesome to describe on a family website. The idea was that it was better for the body to suffer than the soul to perish. Protestants bought into these ideas as well, though not to the same extent. Now, it's not my intention to mock Reverend Mark Woods. Reverend Woods is a Baptist minister and clearly has been taught many of the commonly held beliefs about the Inquisition. The only problem is most of these beliefs are not based in any historical fact. Since the Inquisition is a fairly large topic, today we're only going to focus on its purpose and life-saving acts. Well, in order to understand it, we have to have a medieval view of the world. The Middle Ages were both a beautiful and horrific time to be alive. Death was a constant threat, but faith was everywhere. In fact, the Roman Catholic faith was the driving force behind the Great Republic and monarchies of the Middle Ages. The problem only came about when someone objected to the teachings of the Church. You see, governments understood that all authority comes from God, so it stands to reason that those who preach against the authority of God and His Holy Church are also preaching against the authority of the sovereign. They had the idea that the patron saints of revolution were Judas and Satan. So to actively attack Holy Mother Church was in fact an act of treason. And treason, like today, was punishable by death. Makes sense so far, except there was a problem. Say for instance you live in a town. Maybe your neighbors don't like you so much. So what do? They go tell the ruling lord that you're a heretic. Now, you're brought to court and you're asked about your faith. You, of course, say, I'm not a heretic, but maybe something you say about your faith doesn't sound quite right. Well, the Lord's no theologian. How's he to know whether what you believe is heresy or not? He's only left with one option. That's to execute you, just to be on the safe side. Now, the Church recognized that many people who may never have been heretics were unjustly executed. So in 1184, Pope Lucius III decided to form an organization to determine if someone was preaching heresy. And the accused were not to be executed until the organization had determined whether the person was in fact a heretic. This organization was called the Inquisition. Luckily for historians, the Inquisition kept incredible records, and these records show that the Inquisition was in fact a pro-life organization. Now, it's easy for us today to sit here and judge the Middle Ages for such barbarity as executing heretics, but the governing leaders, as well as the Church, recognized the danger of heresy. Destruction follows when we, as individuals, step outside of our station and usurp the authority of the Church. Christendom recognized the great nightmare that would occur from a theological revolution like the Protestant Reformation, which we are still reeling from today. We'll talk more about the so-called torture aspects of the Inquisition in a later video, when we take a closer look at what is now dubbed the Spanish Inquisition. And I promise you, Spain, you shall be vindicated. However, today it's important for us Catholics to realize the purpose and actions of the Inquisition was to save lives. I'll put up several sources below from Dr. Thomas Madden of St. Louis University if you're looking for more information. So, until next time, have a wonderful day, and Saint Dominic, pray for us.